Vaskirjan with you at the Citrus Bowl. Welcome to the Orlando Rage. Have been the toast of the XFL for the past couple of weeks. 8-2, the best record in the league. They're undefeated here at home, where they're beating their opponents by an average of almost 2 touchdowns a game. But that was the regular season. Tonight in the playoffs, Orlando wants to make a postseason statement. As I welcome Jesse Ventura to the telecast. Ever since that 6-0 start, Jesse, teams have been gunning for Orlando.
That's right. You know, Orlando was the first team to clinch, Matt, so they didn't have as much motivation to play for where their opponents did to make it to the playoffs. Well, Coach Galen Hall needs to get that early motivation back, that early season drive, and he wants to jump start and have a quick start tonight. Look for Orlando to try to score quick for that momentum.
And perhaps, as opposed to weeks past, that jump start might come on the defensive side of the ball for Orlando. One of the guys that might give them that spark is one of their outstanding linebackers, James Burgess. He's standing by with our own Fred Rogan. Freddie.
Obviously, at this time, emotions run high. What do you expect from San Francisco, and what do you have to do to stop San Francisco?
Basically, what we got to do is do good on three phases of the game, offense, special teams, and especially defense. Create a bunch of turnovers, and we'll win this game. And for our fans, hey, y'all ready to rumble? We're going to show you how to rumble, baby. Yeah!
Let's talk about who James Burgess is going to rumble with. The San Francisco Demons have really had to claw their way into the playoffs. This, by the way, tonight is a rematch of a Week 2 game between Orlando and San Francisco that the Rage won 26-14. But as I welcome Mike Adamley to the telecast, Mike, both teams different here in the playoffs. Certainly the San Francisco Demons a different team today.
Well, San Francisco coach Jim Skipper says, Matt, throw that game out so long ago. Plus, we're much improved personnel-wise. Mid-season acquisition of strong safety Toby Wright. Wide receiver Brian Roberson and running back Terry Battle, both different makers, missed that first game because of injury. They're back in the lineup tonight. The big question mark for San Francisco at quarterback. The XFL's most accurate passer, Mike Pawlowski, out of this game with a shoulder injury. His replacement, Pat Barnes. And what he lacks maybe in leadership and mobility, he makes up for with his arm strength and mobility. And last week against Los Angeles, San Francisco had a dickens of the time getting the ball deep. That could change tonight with Pat Barnes in control.
Pat Barnes indeed gets the start for San Francisco tonight. He's standing by with Chris Raggy. Rags.
Pat, the table's set. 2 wins away from $1 million. You get the start tonight. What kind of shots are you going to take?
The best kind. The ones that score points.
You're ready to defeat this Orlando team at home?
Yeah, definitely.
Moments ago, as per usual, the scramble for possession. James Hunden and Scott Kloman. James Hunden, Jay Hunt on the back of his jersey, wins the scramble. San Francisco wins the right to choose whether to kick or receive. Jim Skipper's bunch is chosen to receive in this first ever XFL postseason contest. Unusually hot and humid, even for Orlando this time of year. In fact, this is the warmest game time temperature that the XFL has seen all season long.
And Matt and Mike, those players better make sure they're taking their water throughout this game, because you don't want to get dehydrated in the heat. 90 degrees here today, this afternoon.
Everything on the line tonight. One of these two teams is done for the season. The other goes to the $1 million championship game next Saturday night. Jake Taylor to kick things off for Orlando. And the XFL playoffs are underway. The ball slips through the hands of Terry Battle. He's got to run it out of the end zone. In trouble already is San Francisco, and Battle just gets it out of the end zone. The Demons take over at the 2-yard line.
And that may be that jump start I talked about in the opening right there.
Deuce.
Number 22, Terry Battle, watch closely, tipped the ball, actually. He had no choice but to go and get it and run it back out. And lucky he made it that far.
He made a couple of good moves just to get it out of the end zone. And it's time for Pat Barnes to take over, quarterbacking San Francisco. Making just his third start of the year, Barnes is 1-1 as a starter. Had a great start against Birmingham. 2 TD passes, ran another one in. Struggled in his second start against New York. The San Francisco offense has begun with a completion to Brian Roberson. We talked about the differences briefly, guys, in the open between Pat Barnes and Mike Pulowski. Both of them are Cal Bear alums. Both of them highly decorated at collegiates, but that's probably where the comparison, the similarities rather, end.
Mike Pulowski, the leader of this football team, also a guy with a lot of experience. But Pat Barnes, Jim Skipper was telling us, a guy who likes to take a little gamble now and then and is not afraid to throw the ball deep, which was a problem last week against Los Angeles.
Second and three on the ground for Kelvin Anderson. Perhaps back to the line of scrimmage at most. The defensive backfield got into the play. Omar Brown in on the tackle for Orlando.
Let's go, punt. Punt alert, punt alert.
Tensions already running high in this playoff game tonight in Orlando. Oh, yeah. Reggie Doster and Travis Moore scrapping before the last whistle.
We will see a lot of that tonight. So much on the line.
Third and two. The Demons very good on third down. As you can see, they led the league in third down conversions.
Wide open.
Barnes is going to go deep. He's got Jimmy the Red Cunningham, who can't quite finish.
And what a big play that would have been if Barnes would have laid it out there a little better. He did not. Excellent fake on the play. Gutsy call down on your 10-yard line. They just didn't complete the pass. You have to execute, Mike.
The art of prestidigitation, the pump fake.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Prestidigitation.
There's that pump fake. That's what set it up. Sleight of hand.
Showing off that Northwestern degree again. Mike Banasek back to punt. A gutsy call on third and two from their own 10 to go long. It didn't work for San Francisco. So Panasek booms a big one. Skinny Culver back to receive, starting it at his own 38. He's brought down at the 41-yard line, and that's where the Orlando offense will start their day. The playoffs are underway. We'll be right back.
XFL on NBC.
Orlando and San Francisco are underway at the Citrus Bowl. Scoreless, one possession into the ballgame at three and out by San Francisco. And it's time for Brian Kuklick in the offensive unit of the Rage to take the field. Kuklick took over for Jeff Brohm when he went down with injury during week seven. This is just his fourth professional start. He goes up top looking long for Diallo Burks. A flag on the play, perhaps early PI. Wendell Davis had the coverage on the Rage's leading receiver.
Pass interference, number 21, defense. That's a spot foul, automatic, first down.
San Francisco's defensive game plan, low the front, eight men in the box, 7 minutes, and they give them man-to-man coverage on the outside. Look at the top of your screen, Diallo Burks working one-on-one with Wendell Davis. He didn't make the catch, but he got the interference call, which is just as good.
Liz!
A great start for Brian Kuklick. Long again into the opposite corner, looking for Skinny Culver. Good coverage this time by Kevin Casebehorn.
San Francisco tonight with Orlando so potent at wide receiver. The pressure on their two quarterbacks, Kevin Casebehorn and Dwayne Harper, also Wendell Davis. Basically what San Francisco is saying, Jesse, Kuklick, you're going to beat us.
Yep, and they've got to have their defense start a lot better than they did last week.
Both of these teams are coming off lopsided losses in their final regular season game. That was Derek Clark up ahead for a gain of two or three. San Francisco was shut out last week for the only time all year, and Galen Hall's Rage lost in Chicago. Another lopsided score. The Rage really never got anything going offensively all week last week. They went down 13-0 at half, then 19-0 in the third quarter. They were never in it a week ago. So for both teams, a chance to come back strong here in the playoffs.
Sort of playing around off of.
Brian Kuklick works under the advantage of having a three-back attack that is probably the best in the XFL. Clark, Black, and Shea are all good ones. They rotate themselves and balance out the running attack well.
Me, I'm a elusive back with, you know, a little speed. And Derek is a big back, you know, he's a power runner. Brian Shea is just, you know, he's a little engine that could. I might cut back. DC might run you over. Brian Shea might do both. So, you know, that's kind of hard.
That's Michael Black.
Here we go.
Perhaps one a better straight, outside back, speed right, with Michael right. Black, but it is a three-headed monster. Each of them do different things well. Michael Black has rotated himself in here on this third and nine for the Rage. Kuklick back to pass, dumps it off to the aforementioned Michael Black, who is up ahead, not good for the first down, a gain of only three before Greg Williams puts the hit on him for San Francisco.
And I would say this drive is Orlando comes out to attempt a field goal, a minor success for San Francisco in that they stopped Orlando after having a pretty good field position.
54-56. And the bottom line is you still have to make the kick.
There's an attempt of 42 yards out for Jay Taylor, who was 7 of 9 during the regular season. He was among the surest things in the league. From 42 yards out, Jay Taylor's good. Orlando, the first to score tonight. With a timeout, the U.S. Army presents victories in life. Tonight we look at Orlando Rage receiver Mario Bailey, who's overcome a lifetime of doubts about his size and come up big for his Rage. Mario Bailey, a great example of the U.S. Army's victories in life.
It's always been a problem when people look at me. Just by looking at me, they assume, you know, I'm not a big guy, I'm not tall. So they assume that, well, he's not a football player. You know, I have a hard time getting past security at the game. They question me and want to see my ID and don't think I'm a player. They always want to see the big receivers. When I was coming out, small receivers start disappearing. You start having guys like Terrell Owens, who's like 6'5", 215. There's basketball players out there. It's scarce for a guy my size, so you have to make plays. I pride myself on just being able to make plays. So, you know, like I said, I have to work hard. That's been all my life.
42-yard field goal by Jay Taylor has put the Orlando Rage up early. 3-0 home team here in the first-ever XFL playoff game. Big play on the drive, a 29-yard pass interference play that led to the Taylor boot. And here is Taylor to kick things off with 10:34 left in the first quarter. Terry Battle and Jimmy the Jet Cunningham back to receive. That's Jimmy the Jet, the Canada refugee. Hit hard and knocked out of bounds by Corey Gilliard. San Francisco takes over at their own 21-yard line. Tomorrow at 7 Eastern, the two hottest teams in the XFL fight it out for a chance to play in the million-dollar game. Something has to give when two red-hot teams collide. It's Chicago at Los Angeles, the XFL playoffs, tomorrow at 7 Eastern on UPN. I think whoever wins this one tonight, guys, is going to fear the winner of tomorrow's game, because both of those two teams, LA and Chicago, are playing good football.
Green 15 to the...
Barnes on play action. Looking down the middle. Dumps it off. It's picked off! Picked off by Ben Huff! The defensive tackle who knocked down three passes during the season gets a pick and a touch.
Barnes made a critical mistake. He should have just taken the sack. He panicked. He tried to unload the ball and threw it right to the defensive lineman, and they're down 9-0 now.
Jesse, you talked about it at the top of the telecast. Galen Hall told us his team has struggled of late because they have not capitalized early on a big break, and they finally got one here.
In the postseason in the XFL, there are different rules concerning point after attempts. Up to 3 points. From 1 yard out, it's a one-point try. From 5 yards out, it's worth two. From the 10-yard line, it's a three-point PAT. Those are postseason rules. The Orlando Rage have lined up for 1 point. Derek Clark gets the hand.
I don't think he made it.
San Francisco has held the fort.
And that will come into play somewhere down the line. And if they fall behind, perhaps.
Well, on a 9-point deficit, a touchdown and a 3-point PAT ties the ball game.
Let's go back to Big Ben Huff and the critical mistake by Pat Barnes. Ducked to get out of pressure, and I'm not sure where he... Cedric Clark applying the pressure here. Number 91, nice swim move inside. Pat knows, absolutely knows he shouldn't have thrown that one.
What happened, Mark? Do you have any idea?
Orlando off to a big start at home, making the plays. 9-0 Rage. We'll be right back.
Back in Orlando with Ben Huff, who just scored for the Rage. Ben, a case of being in the right place at the right time?
Just trying to play hard, like the coach said. I'm just pissed off I didn't dance better. Now I got to hear this for another week.
I was going to say, the touchdown was great, but you whiffed on the spike.
I told them to put me on offense, but they didn't want to listen.
I think they made the right call.
Looked like Curly Howard putting out a live hand grenade. I played with his dad, Marty. Marty, a great All-American linebacker at the University of Michigan, watching this game back home.
Terry Battle back.
How old are you, Mike?
Battle up the middle. San Francisco needs a big play. Somebody lost their lid, and Battle's dropped to the 30-yard line. Go ahead, say it, Jesse. I'm waiting for you to say you're the weakest link on this broadcast team, Baskerzin. Beat it.
No way, Matt. No way would I do that.
11 weeks, none of us have been voted off the island, Ben.
Not yet. Well, another chance for Pat Barnes in San Francisco, down 9-0 early here in the first quarter.
Green 16!
They're running.
Green 16! Set up!
Play action to Calvin Anderson. There's a pass out in the flat to Terry Battle, who fumbles the football. And Orlando has recovered.
Wow.
Oh, my goodness. Could things go any worse for Jim Skipper?
Jim Skipper knew he had to play against the Orlando 11 men on defense, but not Murphy's Law as well. Everything that could go wrong has gone wrong tonight for San Francisco. Man. Simple case of Terry Battle not holding on to the football.
Careless
mistake.
Totally careless. He didn't tuck the ball in. He didn't really take a hit. It just got swiped out of his arm. And the worst thing that could happen to San Francisco, turn the ball over deep in their territory again.
Two great plays by Cedric Clark of Orlando to strip the football.
That Rage player down at his back is their outstanding linebacker, James Burgess, the Rage's leading tackler and a guy they can ill afford to be without. James Burgess played almost every snap this year during the regular season. Let's take a look at how he got hurt.
Got kicked in the stomach, so it looks like maybe just the wind knocked out of him.
He got caught with one of those Bruce Lee blocks.
Well, for James Burgess, the playoffs is nothing compared to surviving Hurricane Andrew.
I think that's probably the most scared I've ever been in my life. Just listen to the banging and the loud noise and stuff like that. Pieces of your house coming off. Yeah, I think it makes me appreciate football, life in general. Just the fact that, hey, I live to see another day. There was a lot of people didn't make it. And I feel like, as a family, we was blessed.
Was one of 13 people seeking refuge from the hurricane, running room to room in a small house. And he'll be just fine tonight.
The best thing that could happen here for San Francisco is get their defense to make a big play and get them back in the game.
Another gift for Brian Kuklick and the Rage offensive unit as they take over at the 28 of San Francisco. This is Derek Clark trying to get around the side, banging for nothing. Perhaps a gain of 2 or 3 yards on the play. Kevin Casebehar and Greg Williams make the tackle.
Picking up on our period, second and seven for your Rage.
Okay, Brian, here we go now. 060 hooks gas.
Here we go. Amazing. 060 hooks gas. All one, right?
We have rush room now. Get rid of it.
Rip, 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 rip! Go! Set it!
Second and seven for Orlando. Looking into the end zone for Diallo Burks. It's incomplete, but it flags down on the play. Kevin Casebehard had the coverage.
Casebehard had Diallo Burks covered about as well as a guy can cover a wide receiver of Burks' stature.
When you're playing that tough man-to-man defense, though, you got to come up with plays, and they've been caught now two big pass interference calls. He didn't look back for the ball until it was too late.
Give credit to Brian Kuklick. Burks was not his primary receiver. He actually looked off in one direction and found Burks.
That's the second PI call on San Francisco in the first quarter. The first one on Wendell Davis led to the field goal. And here is Orlando on first and goal here with just over 8 minutes left in the first quarter. We're just underway. That's Derek Clark, and that's an easy touchdown. He ran for seven during the regular season.
You know, I hate to say it, Matt, being from Minnesota, but this has had a start like the Giants and the Vikings.
15-0 Orlando, and people are just settling into their seats. Orlando is going to line up now for the point after try. And we'll see what kind of strategy Galen Hall takes to it. There's another injured player down on the field. That's Jeremy Akers, their outstanding right tackle. The Notre Dame product.
Right there. Where's right now? God.
Let's get, hey. All right.
Coach, this is a little like deja vu all over again. Carbon copy of last week. Can you stop the bleeding out here?
Well, I don't know. We're getting turnovers here. Last week, those guys kind of ran the ball and earned it on us. I mean, we just start off with some turnovers. And there's a lot of football left, so we got to keep on hacking.
And the key will be for San Francisco to remain patient. I know that sounds a little ridiculous being down 15-0, but because don't try to go get it back at once.
Well, you know, Jim Skipper told us yesterday that...
Galen, before the game, you said you needed a spark, something to start quickly. Is this what you were talking about?
Yeah, it really is. We got to keep the pressure on them now. And, you know, hopefully we can play well. They're a dangerous football team. Barnes and the quarterbacks are dangerous, and they can always come back. We got to keep going.
All right, before I was so rudely interrupted there by Fred Rogan, always chomping my bit, I was going to say, Jim Skipper told us yesterday that San Francisco, they need to play emotionally up to beat Orlando today. And so far, with two big turnovers like that, two big penalties like that, it's tough to play emotionally up like
absolutely.
This.
Absolutely. There's nothing that snatches your emotion away quicker than to fall 15 points behind and you're not even halfway through the first quarter.
Ace. Come on, Ace, huddle up.
Orlando has just burned their first time out of the half, and it's interesting to note, fellas, that the Rage have run five plays offensively, and they lead 15-0.
Here we go, 1-800, all one, right?
They've lined up from the one-yard line. They're going for the one-point conversion try to try and make it 16-0. Derek Clark ran in the first. And Mario Bailey catches the second. Orlando making it look easy so far tonight. 16-0 Rage with a lot of time left. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Citrus Bowl. Orlando on top, 16-0. With just over 8 minutes left to play in the first, that's right, the first quarter. Jay Taylor will kick things away. He's got Terry Battle back to receive with Jimmy Cunningham. San Francisco needs to liven things up here. Terry Battle just can't hang on to the football tonight. Brings it out of the end zone and slides down at the 7-yard line. My goodness. Both of these teams have a million reasons to go out there and give everything they got tonight. And next Saturday at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, the moment will finally arrive as either the Rage or the Demons will have a shot at the ultimate payoff. The million-dollar game next Saturday, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific here on NBC.
All right,
NBC.
Here we go. No, yeah, Riddle and Wright, 48 Palm on one, ready. Go! Green 19! Green 19!
Toss back to Kelvin Anderson. No love there. Mark Campbell came in to knock his head off. A loss of two on the play. Well, in addition to playing an emotionally up game, Jim
Great.
Skipper wanted to balance his offense the
Ohio
same way
TKO
Galen Hall
one,
did.
51.
When you start with a 16-0 deficit seemingly at the opening kickoff, it almost puts you in a pass position right out of the chute.
51.
They're not quite at the point yet where they change their game plan completely.
Green 19 to that.
Barnes in his own end zone staying cool. He gets it away, however. I'll tell you what. You got to say this about Pat Barnes. 16 zip, doesn't matter. He's going to get back there and find a spot to throw.
Right by 41.
There was an eligible receiver there.
41 was right there.
Okay. There was a receiver.
Absolutely. 5 yards away.
They're saying there was a receiver, so I think they're going to pick this flag up.
Not bad. I got.
Caleb
there
Holden.
Is no foul. Number 41. Was in the area. The pass is ruled incomplete. Third down.
Jamie Reed of the San Francisco fullback, the man who's somewhere in the vicinity, wherever that may be. Watch number 41, Jamie Reeder. Pat was looking for him.
Oh, there he is.
There he is.
That was a good call.
But the bottom line, 3rd and 11 in there. On their own 7-yard line, so Orlando can bring the house if they choose to here.
Just a 4-man front. It still gets to Barnes, but he slips away. Pat Barnes running for his life and running for a first down for the Demons.
First down.
That is the one thing that Pat Barnes brings to the table that maybe that Mike Pulowski didn't have as much of.
I don't Mike think he intended to do that at all. I think he was scared to death and was trying to find any way to
however
get out of
you, however you go. Do it, Jesse, it counts.
Right.
It came out a positive.
Listen, I'm here to tell you that Pat Barnes, the Pac-10's leading passer in 96, a guy that holds 7 Pac-10 conference records, every bit the field general that Mike Pulowski is, San Francisco is down but far from out.
3-19! Stop!
Hands to Kelvin Anderson up the middle. Bounces off one hit. Kelvin Anderson still on his feet. A gain of 7 for San Francisco.
And that's the key right now. San Francisco can't panic here. There's a lot of football. You got almost 3.5 quarters to go. If they get a sustained drive, get in the end zone, they're back in the game.
And you remember when you had to be about 6'1 and 225 to play running back in any football league? Well, Kelvin Anderson, like a lot of backs, both in the NFL, the XFL, short, stocky, built like bowling balls,
in fact,
closer to the ground.
In fact, I'm sitting next to one.
3-19 to that.
Barnes with a little more time this time. Now he gets flushed out. Everybody covered well downfield. He finally airs it out.
Kelvin Anderson!
What the fuck?
All the way out of the backfield. Kelvin Anderson across the 30-yard line. A gain of 40 for the Demons.
And that's just what the doctor ordered for Jim Skipper. He scrambled out of the pocket, found his receiver downfield, big play, and San Francisco's back in the game.
And if you're a wide receiver, one of the things they teach you, your quarterback in trouble, find an open space. Kelvin Anderson did, and they had him on a linebacker,
nice
too.
Catch.
So a mismatch that Pat Barnes was able to exploit, even though it came on a broken play.
3-28.
Travis Moore, the man in motion, out of the forward blast. Barnes will look to pass it again down to Brian Roberson in the flat. A gain of a couple. Omar Brown and Jimmy Clements on the tackle.
Easy, easy.
even with Pat Barnes at quarterback.
Give me black left. Give me a 51 Aztec Zipper 8.
Here we go. Black left. 51 Aztec Zipper 8. On one, right? 51 Aztec Zipper 8. Black left. Go! Black left. Timeout, timeout.
And Barnes doesn't like what he sees. A good drive, and Barnes doesn't want to let it go to waste. San Francisco trying to come back here in the first quarter. Plenty of time.
It's all right. Hey.
San Francisco Demons in the midst of their finest drive of the night. One that's already consumed six plays and 68 yards. In fact, this drive has had San Francisco run more plays than Orlando has run all night.
Come here.
But look at the scoreboard.
35 Dallas. Gunner, 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 go. 35 Dallas.
Some confusion on the play call. Guy got in there and really applied some pressure to Barnes, and Pat's lucky just to get it away as he had Andre Purvis coming up in his dish.
All right. Okay, okay. Okay, I hear you. Relax. 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 There we go. Doubles left. 35 Dallas, backside 28. 35 on one, ready? 35. Money, money, money. Go. 319.
San Francisco shows the same set now on third down. Calvin Anderson in the backfield with Barnes. A little more time. Got a man wide open and overthrown Travis Moore. Oh, my goodness.
There was the play to get him back in the football game. Moore wide open over the middle, and Barnes just hung it out too long.
First series of the game, he had Jimmy Cunningham wide open on that pump fake, and then threw that one a little bit off his back foot. Sure touchdown.
So here's Mike Panasek now, the former drama teacher from Lebanon, Indiana, who took a leave of absence to kick field goals in the XFL. A 42-yarder by Panasek is good to put the Demons on the scoreboard at the Citrus Bowl tonight.
Now, courtesy of Busch Beer, let's take a look at how the Orlando Raids got here. The Rage clinched the East title with a win over the New York Hitmen. Brian Shea took back the opening kick 95 yards to set up an easy touchdown.
Look at Brian Shea go! At the 40, makes a move!
Brian Kuklick, making his first start for the Rage, threw a TD to Diallo Burks to put Orlando at 7-1.
We got us 7-1. We got two more to go. Two more right now, that's right. Then we got two more to go.
Hell yeah!
Four games left.
Yes. We might have a smash.
Well, San Francisco able to get on the scoreboard after a nice drive. They failed to convert the touchdown, but those points, that's an important psychological lift after going behind 16 zip.
Well, there's also another negative for Orlando. When you get things, and Mike can tell you this, when they come too easy, too quick, you can get a tendency to back off a little bit, lose your intensity. You think you got it made.
Orlando's also been the beneficiary of bad field, or good field position. Also, the turnovers at San Francisco self-inflicted.
This game's far from over.
Brian Shang, the former Emporia State standout, to begin this kick return at his goal line. Dropped around the 22-yard line. That's where the Rage will take over with 2:36 left in the first quarter.
Hey, tell the back not to be offset if he can help it.
1-800 on one, right? Stay behind him.
Michael Black is the back that's rotated in for Orlando. In the self-policing unit, here comes Eric England. Look out. Before he's ripped out of bounds, he gets it off to Mario Bailey. There goes Super Mario Brothers, still on his feet before John Haskins can trip him up at the 43. A gain of 20 for Orlando.
Brian Kuklick keeping this play alive. His rollout here. Thought maybe about throwing the ball away, but saw Mario Bailey instead. And this guy can do a lot of things in the open field with the football tucked underneath his arm. What was a sack turns into a 20-yard gain for Orlando.
Hey, just tape it up. Flag.
On the ground, and there is a flag on the play. Michael Black, the ball carrier, dropped by Toby Wright.
Holding.
And indeed, holding on Orlando.
Where are we here? Take it. You're going to take the 10 yards. Previous spot. Holding. Number 73, offense. 10-yard penalty. Repeat. First down.
Penalties really got in the way of Orlando's attempt to win their ninth of the season last week. Penalties, couple of drops, couple of turnovers, not the kind of stuff that happened against the Orlando Rage all season long. They played very clean football.
Liz!
Trademark of Galen Hall teams.
Go!
That penalty, the first on the Rage tonight. Here's Kuklick to throw. He's got a completion to the Yellow Birds. A gain of 11 for Orlando. They get some of that back.
There you go. Good job, baby.
San Francisco defensive line facing a similar problem to the one they faced last week when Tommy Maddox from Los Angeles. Those short three-step drops. Brian Kuklick doing much the same thing here.
This Michael Black. Run. Michael couple Black. Of guys yeah. miss him. Three guys miss him. Got to wrap him up.
Oh, man. Just bad tackling right there.
Greg Williams, the Demons' free safety, had them all wrapped up and couldn't make the tackle.
There you go. Boop. Get it. Oh, God.
Oh, that's just a lot of guys just grasping for straws and trying to tackle his head. It's a gain of 12, and they move the chains at first down for Orlando.
Also, a lot of arm tackling. You got to go through the man. You can't stop one of these backs with your arms today.
Final seconds ticking down on the first quarter. One that the Rage had dominated. There's Diallo Burks again. End of quarter, and it was a good one.
You're watching the XFL on NBC.
Fresh 15-minute clock here for the start of the second quarter. It starts with a hand to Brian Shea. He's wrapped up for a loss on the play. Craig Powell in on the tacklers for San Francisco. First quarter dominated by Orlando in rather unusual fashion. Two San Francisco turnovers certainly play a big part as Orlando got their 16 points
and
on only
zero,
five plays.
0-24
Y under on one, right?
And not only that, but bad special teams play on the kickoffs. They started twice inside their 10.
Play-action pass here on third and one.
San Francisco brings the blitz. Gets picked up nicely. Greg Powell gets to him, however.
That's why you never give up on a play right there. Powell went down, got back to his feet, and still made a big sack.
A loss of 10 on third down and a big stop for San Francisco.
And because Powell was coming all the way, never got a chance to get that play-action mode. Give credit to the Brian Shea for picking him up momentarily, but Kuklick never had a chance to get that ball off.
XFL's leading punter is on to kick it away. It's a live ball at the 18-yard line. Jimmy the Jet Cunningham returned one punt for a score against New York earlier during the regular season. This one bounces out of the end zone.
Mike could be on that show, The Missing Link.
Shea. Go! Green 18!
Cro-Magnon boy.
Green 18.
Matt Barnes completed four passes for 9 yards so far. That one's complete after Sean Manuel, the tight end, seldom used as a pass catcher in this San Francisco offensive schematic. That's a gain of 15 and a first down for San Francisco.
Easy.
You got Tarzan in. Give me Tarzan left. Give me seven ocean.
Here we go. Tarzan left. Seven ocean on one, right?
Tarzan left.
Where's Jane at, Mike?
Go! Seven ocean. Hit it.
358. Miami. 358.
Juan Johnson has checked into the game. That's a gain of three. Juan Johnson has been injured for much of the latter portion of the season for San Francisco, and really a great story in that he, on his own nickel, chose to travel with the team down the stretch to be with his mates and cheer him on to victory to try and get into the postseason. You know, he wasn't on the roster, not earning any money, still forking over the cash for airfare to be with the guys.
Juan Johnson, number 26. For the love of the game.
Former Utah Ute. In the backfield here on second and eight. A couple of yips at the line. Hand to Kelvin Anderson. And a flag on the play.
Come on, baby.
I'm impressed with what Pat Barnes has done in the huddle. His control and command on this team. His leadership in there, keeping everybody under control.
We'll take it.
Despite falling behind 16-0.
Well, there's no reason for him to panic yet. There's a lot of time in this game. They march down here. They get points on the board again, and they're down to single-digit lead. Orlando.
Andre Purvis, the guy that flinched for Orlando.
Courtesy of Pat Barnes.
Who's up?
Inflection.
Tarzan right. Okay. Give me four Zoro.
Here we go. Tarzan left for Zorro. On one, ready?
Second and short.
Green 18.
Not to get Guy Williams or Johnny Weissmuller. Tarzan and Zorro
Green
both involved
18.
In this play.
That's Kelvin Anderson, and that's a first down for San Francisco. Patrice Alexander on the stop for Orlando.
Conspicuous in his absence from the Rage defensive front seven, number 51, linebacker James Burgess, who left the game after getting kicked in the ribs. Right now, San Francisco having success running between the tackles.
That's a hold that Burgess is generally there to stop on every play. Barnes on the quick drop, got a receiver down the middle. That's Brian Roberson. Roberson's lost his helmet twice tonight. Doesn't matter if he catches it. I don't think he minds as much.
Brian Roberson, a wide receiver that San Francisco or Orlando did not have to take account of in the first game because he was injured and did not play, and he can make a difference for this ball team.
And there's another Rage player down on the field injured.
Reggie Doster, the guy that knocked the helmet off, and Roberson says, yeah, we bad, just like Gene Wilder and Richard Pryor and Stir Crazy.
He bad too.
Speaking of stir crazy. San Francisco trying to charge towards perhaps an end zone strike here with 10:21 left in the second quarter.
Red,
43 yards rather, into a drive.
Gunner, go! Set up!
Barnes with a little flip back to Terry Battle, trying to run the option play that didn't work. Cedric Clark jumped on it, and yesterday Pat Barnes told us he wasn't real comfortable with that particular play in the package. Perhaps we just saw why.
You know, every time San Francisco gets close to thinking they're getting back in this game, they shoot themselves right in the foot, step all up. Look at that.
And if you're not accustomed to running the option, it's very difficult to pick up in just 1 week time. It's all about spacing between yourself and the running back. I think Terry was charging the line of scrimmage a little bit, the space between him and Pat Barnes.
And I think it's also called looking the ball in before you start running.
When you do, exhale all your air out.
Go! Set it!
Diallo Burks out of the blast in forward motion. Pass goes his way, and he drops the football. It has been a rough night for Terry Battle. Twice in the end zone on kickoff returns, and that play right there that gave Orlando the ball back.
Rip. I got four three.
Second and ten. San Francisco defense really hasn't had a chance to catch its breath, and Burks drops another one. Same play. Now, this happened last week with Brian Kuklick trying to get it out there to his receivers against Chicago. What's going through Kuklick's mind right now?
Come on, huddle up. Z-0, 60 hooks on one, right?
You know, by the way, Diallo Burks is probably their best receiver threat.
Liz!
Not until he catches it.
Man. Third and 10 now after a couple of drops, and that one's flat out incomplete. Kevin Casebehart had the coverage on Skinny Culver, and Orlando is going to have to punt. What a disappointing way to gain possession after a turnover.
Swaying your wide open. I mean, on slant. That's all.
You know, let me tell you, it's a 13-point deficit, but Orlando's had a chance to really bury San Francisco tonight, and they have not been able to do it.
Frisco's defense is playing pretty well, really.
Flag on the play. Jimmy Cunningham starts the return in his end zone, and he's dropped at the 8.
We got three flags on the play.
Are you going to go around him, or are you going to call up the phone?
He's playing out here. He's playing over there, out yard, 8 yards.
All right.
'97 white holding, what do you have?
And we got red team, 54 downfield, too early on the kick.
So we got to bring it all back and just play for ourselves.
Sounded like they're going to replay the down. Well, I got one guy giving the business. What do you got?
Ineligible receiver downfield, number 54, holding. Number 97, those penalties were offset. Repeat, fourth down.
Never mind.
Repeat, coach, fourth down.
I'm not sure who gets the advantage on this one.
Well, you figured Jimmy Cunningham's return gave San Francisco possession at the 8-yard line. It's tough to march him back any farther than that.
Got it. Been holding on us.
Love her, by the way. My own added unsolicited commentary
ever since Jerry Maguire.
Here's Jimmy Cunningham now to start the return to the 2-yard line, and guess what? The same result.
We didn't even need to do it.
A lonely seat for Terry Battle, who has had a rough start to this first ever XFL playoff game. His demons take the field offensively without him to start things at their own 8-yard line. Barnes to throw, dumps it off to Kelvin Anderson, who misses one tackler, gets hit hard and dropped at the 21-yard line by Corey Gilliard.
And Terry, I know it's been a tough night holding on to the ball, but there may be a reason why.
Well, there's no excuses. I just need to get my head into the game. So I'm just trying to come back, having a hard time breathing right now. So next week, next half, I'm trying to make something up.
Terry Battle, we're told, is working on a case of bronchitis tonight. That is Corey Gilliard, one of a couple of guys in that Orlando defensive backfield who started every game this season.
This is how he got hurt. The strong safety in the Rage's defensive alignment. And watch Kelvin Anderson. Boom. That was helmet to helmet, and Corey unfortunately got the worst of that.
That's a running back delivering the blow.
Kelvin Anderson's one of those guys, I think you described it earlier, Mike, built like a bowling ball, just absolutely low to the ground and powerful, and it's good to see Gilliard okay after taking that hit from him.
Oh, yeah, he'll be fine. He's running off. He just got his bell rung.
There have been some bell ringings tonight, let me tell you. Oh, man.
Corey running.
Go! 319!
That linebacking core is still without James Burgess. Orlando's leading tackler. Barnes gets it out to the one-man show. Kelvin Anderson once again. Sean Banks, big hands from Texas Tech, makes the tackle.
James, earlier you were kneed in the ribs. You're out here now. Your ribs are wrapped. What is your condition? Can you play?
I think I can play. We're going to go in halftime and see the suggestion. And if I feel like I can go out there and play, I'm going to come back and play.
Second and seven now.
He's breathing, Matt.
He'll be back.
He's got heartbeat. Green 88 tonight.
Out of the shotgun now, Barnes has a nice pocket to work from and gets a completion out to Brian Roberson.
And that time his helmet stayed on.
That'll be close to a first down for San Francisco.
Twins! Gun, gun, gun! Gunner, gunner,
no need
gunner,
to measure. Gunner, they mark it as a first water. Down for the Demons. And no need to huddle.
Gonna go!
Back this other way.
In the hurry-up offense, out of the shotgun is Barnes again. He's flushed out of the pocket, finding a target. It's Jimmy the Jet Cunningham, who can't hang on to the football.
I tell you, if you're a wide receiver with Pat Barnes throwing you the ball, you got to stay awake at all times. This guy is going to get off the hook. This guy is going to make a play. So if you're a wide receiver, hey, man, I could come to you at any time. You got to catch the football.
And we've seen a lot of drop passes tonight. The quarterbacks are throwing the ball on the money. The receivers are dropping them.
Galen Hall told us yesterday that he fears the elusiveness of the San Francisco skill position guys. Guys like Jimmy the Jet, guys like Kelvin Anderson, who really have to wrap up to tackle.
Time out. I want to time out. I just couldn't audible.
And Barnes burns San Francisco's second timeout. Orlando on top. We'll be right back. Back from the Citrus Bowl. Just about 6 minutes left to play here in the first half. And San Francisco trying to put together a drive. Nothing more than a field goal so far for the Demons. Barnes rolling. Flushed out once again and on the move. He has to eat it as he's taken down by Cedric Clark. A loss of a yard on the play. Well, as banged up as Orlando is defensively, they're without their leading tackler. We've already seen guys in their secondary go down. They're managing to keep the blankets pretty tight on the San Francisco receivers.
Makes refugees from Jacobs Field.
Makes you long for the guy at Cleveland Muni.
Barnes in trouble again.
And he can't get it away. Again, it's Cedric Clark right in the middle of the mayhem.
That just comes off like that, doesn't it?
Now the emotional Barnes keeps it in check. Punting unit on as Mike Panasek's out to kick it. It's a live ball at the 49-yard line.
Skinny left early.
A wobbler for Skinny Culver. Starts the return at the 43 and is knocked out with a flag at the 48-yard line. Plenty of flags, only four penalties so far tonight.
Maybe that's him.
That's got to be an offensive coordinator on the phone.
Joe, here's that.
Shoot. Yeah, I know. I lost vision of the guy inside. I wanted to get trapped. You know, because the corner's lying way outside, right at the first down depth. So. Yeah. All right. You got it. All right. Yeah.
The next best thing to being there. Joe Pow, the offensive coordinator, can't beat Pat Barnes, but he can tell him what to do. And sees things that Pat doesn't see maybe down there.
Block in the back call on the punt return marches things back for Orlando, and nobody is close to that one.
three was pass as well. Second and 10,
go.
What both these quarterbacks have in common, Pat Barnes
zero,
and Brian Kuklick.
Here we go. 0-14, check 15 on one, right?
Is that each of them are aggressive. Both of them are gamblers. Kuklick threw 10 picks in just three starts. That led the XFL, no, by the way.
Hey, check, 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 check. Go.
Inside of 4 minutes now. This is Michael Black trying to get around Kevin Case-Beharn and finally brought down by Case-Beharn after a gain of 7.
This kind of cutback runs absolutely killed San Francisco a week ago when Los Angeles Saladin McCullough did him in.
Let me tell you, the Orlando offense has hardly lit the world on fire. All their points came within the first 6 minutes of the game, and they came on gifts by San Francisco.
San Francisco's lost the game so far. Orlando hasn't won it.
Liz!
Kuklick is 0 for his last four passing. You got to factor in a couple of brutal drops in there. Hangs it up in the corner for Diallo Burks and or Mario Bailey. It's incomplete.
And that offensive line for Orlando, their strong suit, absolutely caved in that time by San Francisco's front four. Kuklick never got the ball, had a chance to get the ball off, actually tripped over one of his own offensive linemen. Watch him backpedal there. His running back, actually, Michael Black. And then the pressure by strong safety Toby Wright on the blitz.
Look at this, bad
snap.
Taylor's got to go and run for it. It's still bouncing around. He still doesn't have control. He gets hit. It's a free ball. Who picks it up?
It don't matter. It's their ball. That's fourth down.
On fourth down, a change of possession indeed.
And finally, San Francisco gets a break.
Jermaine Miles, bad ankle and all, put the fear of everybody in Jay Taylor, and he couldn't find the handle on the football.
And maybe Mr. Murphy changed jerseys, too. Backup linebacker Ritz Young is the snapper, long snapper for the Orlando Rage. That was long, all right.
This is the kind of break Jim Skipper and the Demons have been looking for ever since the opening whistle. This is Kelvin Anderson hanging onto that football like it's its only child. He says he's in the end zone.
And the referee says no.
Big Hands Banks stopped him at the goal line.
Knee down before he's reached out and crossed the plane with the football. I like what Kelvin Anderson has been doing for this San Francisco offense tonight.
And I say you give the ball right back to Kelvin again. There's the handoff. Kelvin sees his opening, drives to the goal line. A good call by the official. Very good. He was not in.
Kelvin Anderson was acquired.
Fumble!
Fumble in the end zone!
Do you believe that? Do you? No, they're calling it a touchdown. They're saying he broke the plane. Oh, is this crowd going to get mad on that one?
A quarterback sneak by Pat Barnes. He tried to wheel it in with that extra inch. The ball popped free. Let's take a look.
One of the refs called it a touchdown. He broke the plane.
The touchdown is confirmed.
1 point in the center. In the center.
And San Francisco is going to try a 1 point conversion.
Keep this in mind about tonight's officials. This group was voted here by the head of officiating, Carl Pagnali. They were rated based on their performance this year. They are here on the merit of their gamesmanship during the course of the season.
Who made the call, Vince?
A bad snap on fourth down with the punting team on the field gave San Francisco possession inside the 10.
San Francisco has one timeout remaining.
A controversial
Orlando
touchdown call. And now San Francisco takes a timeout.
Noise is going to be a factor.
Oh, this is getting good. Inside of 2 minutes and a half, and we'll be right back.
They owe us. I don't care. God owes us. We got somebody. Great.
Controversy in Orlando after a quarterback sneak results in a touchdown call. The Cleveland refugees just want to bang their drum all day. Guy on the right scares me. And San Francisco will line up for a one-point conversion try.
319!
This is as riled up as the Orlando fans have been all night, and the reason for that is because San Francisco, after a big deficit to start tonight, trails by only six.
Nice call, Joe.
Hold it up. Let's line up.
Big play.
Line up. Hey, get in the V so we can see who's here. Line up. Back up. Let's line up. Line up. Hey, listen. Let's create another turnover. Now, let's go get out. Let's get down there and blow them up. Blow!
Hey, watch the fake.
Jim Skipper coach teams thrive on emotion, and they certainly have snatched it out of the jaws of what was once a 16-0 deficit. It's worth noting at this point, guys, that the biggest deficit San Francisco overcame all year was only 6 points.
Let's go.
Undeterred, they are on the way back tonight. Mike Panasek on to kick it with 1:55 left in the half. Brian Shea, the deep return man for Orlando. Here's Shea at the 11. Fumble! The ball's loose. Let's sort out the pile. And San Francisco recovers!
Wow.
Oh my goodness!
They could have the lead before the half.
This is the screwiest this XFL game I've seen.
You gotta love it.
All year long. Such reversal of fortunes. Marvin Coleman and Wendell Davis were in to scoop it up. Here's where Shea coughed up the football.
Oh, it's loose all the way. Total fumble, no doubt about that one.
Marvin Coleman gathered it in, and San Francisco takes over at the 26.
Go!
Another chance for Pat Barnes. They've got the tight end set in now with the fullback Jamie Reeder back there. Play action to Kelvin Anderson. And Barnes in the corner. He had a man wide open, and it's picked off by Kelly Malvo. The former University of Arizona Wildcat.
Brian Shea off the hook.
Kelly popped tonight, Brian. I'm not sure where Pat Barnes was looking at here.
I have no idea. There wasn't any receiver anywhere around.
Right behind, immediately behind Kelly Malvo was a receiver. And there was no pressure really on Pat.
That's two big mistakes by Barnes in this game. One giving Orlando a touchdown, and this one possibly costing them a touchdown.
Boy, you'd think these two teams have planned for a chance to get into the million-dollar game or something. Here's a handoff to Derek Clark up the middle for a couple of yards to give the Orlando offense a little breathing room.
I got a feeling Galen Hall's going to just be happy to let this half run out and go in with a six-point lead.
Back up.
Looks like I picked the wrong night to stop sniffing glue.
My flag! Ow!
The battle away from the battle between wide receiver and defensive back. The veteran Dwayne Harper getting his legs cut out from underneath him. And veterans don't like that.
Yeah. Dwayne Harper saying, listen, Kevin Swain, I'm older, I'm wiser, and more cunning than you are.
They get Derek Clark. Aubrey battle in on the stop for San Francisco. Nephew of...
Nobody using timeouts here. Frisco with one left could stop the clock once more and try to get the ball back, but apparently they don't want to.
Do you want to hear how Aubrey Battle's a nephew of Sidney Moncrief, Jess?
Sure.
Great story.
Tell us.
Aubrey Battle's the nephew of Milwaukee Buck great Sidney Moncrief. And when we asked him about it, he didn't know it, right? Am I in his will? Third and six now, and San Francisco just takes their final timeout out of the half.
Now, why do you wait, Mike, 15 seconds to call that timeout? Why would you call it right when the play's over?
Got it? Hey.
Now,
courtesy of Busch Beer, let's take a look at how the San Francisco Demons got here.
Winning is what bonds a team together. Feel what it's going to feel like when we win this thing. Knowing we're going to the playoffs. Knowing we got a shot. Feel that right now.
The Demons faced the Outlaws with a playoff berth on the line. They got an early score off special teams, and later Mike Pulaski hit Terry Battle for a 25-yard touchdown to send the Outlaws home and the Demons to the dance.
Oh. We're down.
Jim Skipper's Demons have had their backs to the wall seemingly all year long.
I would too. Get out of here. Yep. Yep. It's all right with it.
What's Skip say? I wish we could get out of here. I don't think he's talking about the Citrus Bowl. I think he's talking about this half.
All right. Nice. That's going to be the quarter.
Final seconds tick away on an unusual half of football. In the end, it's just a six-point contest as the teams go to the locker rooms. This thing is wide open. It's anybody's chance to go to the million-dollar game with a win tonight. We'll be back after this word from your local NBC stations. A crazy first half of football. Stephen Fisher is now the return man for Orlando, unseating Brian Shea. And a great single-man tackle made to save a touchdown by Greg Williams. Fumbles, interceptions, bad snaps.
1-800.
Ace.
Let's take a look at our halftime stats brought to you by Miller Genuine Draft. The turnovers, the big story. Four of them by San Francisco. Minus nine rushing yards by the three-headed running back monster of Orlando.
You know, you look at that and you see Orlando's offense has done nothing, and yet they got the lead in the game.
That was San Francisco's game plan, too. We'll stop your run. Brian Kuklick, try to beat us if you can.
That pass is complete to Mario Bailey, tackled by Dwayne Harper. Last time these two teams met, Orlando ran for 140 yards en route to a 26-14 win. Minus rushing total in the first half, yet because of the turnovers, they're still on top by six.
First down. 0-14, first down.
That's the three-headed monster. They have not accomplished much.
It doesn't look like much of a monster to me, Matt. Not the first half.
This is Michael Black taking a hand up the middle, tackled by Craig Powell as a heavy thought from the pyrotechnics covers the field of play.
Orlando also 0-for-5 on third down conversions in the first half.
Look at this. Like the halftime of Super Bowl IV where they recreated the War of 1812.
Where's Oliver Stone?
Check. 960 choice.
0-50 draw, check. 960 choice. All one, right? Kuklick has a chance now to run one of two plays, a draw play here, or check off to a pass play with six-man protection.
No!
Receivers have their choice of running a short route. Good enough to make the first down. They run the draw instead.
Michael Black, nothing doing. Jermaine Miles, Eric England, and company in on the tackle, and a three and out is how Orlando starts the second half.
And I'll tell you, the Big Mo is switching here. The Big Mo is switching to San Francisco momentum.
Galen Hall told us how active the defense is up front for San Francisco. They've really done their job. They're not the ones coughing up the football.
No, you think the snapper's a little worried? He got that one right in there.
Jay Taylor just gets it away before Jermaine Miles could get this thing. Here's Jimmy Cunningham now, caught it right on his pad, and he turns it upfield, tackled at the 31. 46-yard punt, 8 yards on the return. There was some crazy play in the first half tonight. The bad snap, and that explains the negative rushing yards for Orlando tonight. And then right after that, two plays later, the controversial touchdown on the sneak by Pat Barnes. The result is a six-point game here in the second half.
3-19!
Jamie Reeder, the man in motion. Kelvin Anderson takes the handoff. And he makes something out of nothing, a gain of four before James Roberson gets to him.
They can.
Who
Here we go. Riddler left stay.
Cutter.
Nine. Riddler left stay. Nine palm pipe. On one, ready?
Look for
go, green 19. Green 19. Stop. Go.
Pitch back to Kelvin Anderson. Breaks number of tackles and gets it up near the 40-yard line. A gain of 4 yards again.
58. I thought you was ready. I thought you was ready.
He's talking to Patrice Alexander, the Orlando linebacker.
Go! They can't tackle me!
He's right about that. Omar Brown can't tackle him. Patrice Alexander can't tackle him.
Got those Earl Campbell thighs. Pita Elisara is the player down on the running play.
And if we had a best hair category, there's my pick.
On that note, just log on to XFL.com. We'll create one. We'll be right back.
The down marker. Well, what's he doing? Ball's way up here.
San Francisco Demons looking at a third and two from their own 39.
319. War. 319. Is it hot?
Hand up the middle, and a gain of a couple of yards by Kelvin Anderson.
It's going to depend on the spot, but I think they got it.
How valuable has Kelvin Anderson become to San Francisco's offense? This is a guy that they've only had for half the season, yet he's their leading rusher this year.
I can see why. He runs the ball hard. He protects it well.
Here we go. Doubles left. 65.
Fairly Jet. Good speed Lucy, on the I'm corner. Right. Runs Jet. Tough inside Lucy. The tackles.
He had planned to go back to school at Southeast Missouri State to pursue his criminal justice degree before coming back to football, and he could not have made a better decision, according to the Demons.
Average not great, but those are 26 important yards that he has gained.
Barnes up top, not a contact on the field.
Flags all over the place.
He was looking for Titus Winans. Reggie Doster had the coverage.
It is the one element that was missing from San Francisco's attack last week, throwing the ball deep. And again, even if you don't complete the pass, at least you give the sensation that you can go deep.
On the defense. Spot foul.
He grabbed him by the shirt. David! David, did you not see him grab him by the shirt? Did you not see the receiver grab him? David!
Obviously he didn't.
David's ignoring him. David, of course, that official that made the call. I don't know about a shirt grab. There was plenty of contact. Well, there's the shirt grab.
19!
A big first down for 19. San Francisco on a penalty, however, as they take over at the 31. Here's Kelvin Anderson, a familiar theme around the left side. Good for a couple of yards.
He's got that. Is that all you got looking in your
yeah.
face?
Bring it. Bring some more.
The important thing
black
is
left. Good.
4 yards on first down, 5 yards on first down.
We're going to the right.
You stay in. You stay in.
Yo.
Fifth 19. Play of the drive, second Miami and five Miami now for San Francisco. Barnes out of the shotgun. Roberson was the man in motion. It's complete to Brian Roberson with plenty of room to run. Tackled at the 10. A gain of 15 for the Demons before Sean Banks could get there.
And he'd have got more if Travis Moore hadn't missed a downfield block, because Travis Moore was in position to make a great block downfield, and he missed it.
By and large,
watch
these
this,
Demons
Mike.
Wide receivers, yeah, they're pretty
Look
good
at, here's
downfield
Moore
blockers.
Down there, and he misses the block.
Yep. Got to do better than that, Travis.
Brian Roberson, so far the Demons' leading receiver. He was inactive week two when these two teams met. That was something we talked about earlier. He's already made a difference tonight. Little pass out the flat to Jimmy the Jet Cunningham. Great speed after the catch. He almost gets himself into the end zone.
And he's hurt after that dive, too. He lost his helmet.
The Demons' leading receiver and a man they can ill afford to miss.
Hopefully he just got the wind knocked out of him.
Hands up.
Sometimes you pay the price for extra effort.
And we may be finding out if Orlando can come from behind. We know they can in the regular season, but we may find out whether they can in the playoffs. Jimmy the Jet looks like he lost an engine.
It's a guy who caught at least two passes in every regular season game this year.
They lose him, San Francisco down to just three wide receivers.
I think he's going to be back.
And it's tough to tell what happened there. The extra athletic ability of Jimmy the Jet being shown there, but that's also what paid the price. A timeout on the field. San Francisco driving. We'll be right back. Jimmy the Jet Cunningham, the Demons' leading receiver, sidelined for the moment. We'll check in as to the extent of the injury in a moment. Meanwhile, second and goal for San Francisco on the Orlando 1. They try to sneak it in again. This time a lot less controversial. Touchdown, San Francisco.
Oh, absolutely.
Well, a tie game now, and now the postseason rules come into play again. What does Jim Skipper want to do as far as a PAT try?
You go for one from the one.
Just go for one. Yeah,
absolutely. You go for the lead the easiest way you can get it.
You guys bore me. To recap the rule, for those of you just tuning in late, in the postseason, the XFL PAT rules are different. A one-point conversion from the one-yard line on a runner pass, as per usual. But you can also try for a two-point conversion from the five or a three-point conversion from the 10. And San Francisco's taking a timeout.
Hey, you called something that we never... What's it called? They called something that was not on our play sheet.
And now, Burger King presents the XFL Defensive Player of the Week. In the land of burgers, Whopper is king. New York hitman corner Joey Elams intercepted two passes against the Bolts in a 22-0 shutout win. One was converted into a score when he lateraled off to Donnie Caldwell, who took it in for a touchdown. Elams ended the season number two in interceptions with four overall. That was the Burger King XFL Defensive Player of the Week. In the land of burgers, Whopper is king.
We talked about it with both coaches yesterday, and Jim Skipper told us you let the game dictate what you do on the PAT. And as you guys mentioned, I kid you about it, this is no time to get fancy with the three-point conversion attempt.
Well, you know, when you look at both coaches, Jim Skipper looks very relaxed right now on the sidelines. Galen Hall does not look that way on the Orlando side of the field.
Galen's got the look of a man who's just seen his team blow a 16-0 lead. With no signs of generating any kind of offense to regain that lead.
All 16 Orlando points within the first 5 minutes of the game.
Go! 319! Miami, Miami!
This is a point after attempt for San Francisco to try and break the tie. Play action to Calvin Anderson, a pass into the corner.
No good.
And the PAT is incomplete.
Why do you throw with a running back like that from the one? Oh.
We'll answer these and other questions when we return. At one point tonight, the Orlando Rage led 16-0. San Francisco, as they've done all season, has clawed their way back in this thing. We're tied here in the third. And the man returning the kick, almost beheaded by Otis Floyd, Stephen Fisher, just got his head knocked off.
Now, I'm not so sure when you're on the one-yard line, you got a back like Kelvin Anderson who's ripping hole through the defense. You run a play like this, you got to go for 3 points there with a...
Coach, you're back in this thing, but with all due respect, the rationale behind the call on the point after, what was it?
Well, what happened was we called a formation that Pat wouldn't shore up, so he called the timeout so we wouldn't screw it up. because you never know. At 16-16, that was, might have been the winning point. So that ain't a bad timeout.
But a pass play there at the end when you're on the one-yard line.
Hey, you can call run or pass. Hey, anything goes. If it goes, then it's good. It don't matter what you call.
I think
it don't.
Well, that Skip's way of saying if it worked, that was a genius. So get out of my face.
Yeah.
Go!
We have not seen much of Kuklick and the Orlando offense. This is Michael Black, and they got nothing going on with the running game tonight. A loss of a yard on the play. Eric England and Pete Talamamau there for the tackle.
They were open about it. They were bold about it. We're going to game plan this thing. We're going to put 8 men in the box, 9 men in the box. You try to run it against us, you won't be able to. So, Brian Kuklick, you've got to do your job at quarterback and beat us, and so far he has not.
There's Big Penny. Big Penny Talamamau making a start tonight. Nothing on the ground for Orlando tonight. That story was just the opposite first time these two teams met, and Eric England is there to put his mitts on that pass and knock it down.
Clearly not the same team we saw earlier in the year with Jeff Brohm at quarterback.
What's up, mama?
And Eric England's wishing he had that play over again, because that had nothing but 6 points written all over it had he just caught it.
Hey, you know what? In defense of Brian Kuklick, he made only 3 starts.
Here we go. Zero,
and passed
50
for
screen,
exactly 1 yard 60, less 60, 60, than 60. Jeff Brohm did all season long in 6-plus starts. But he is one of his last 7 here tonight. Third and a long.
Flag.
And the yips on the line of scrimmage. Eric England is claiming he was drawn offsides.
Third and 17, Mike.
I don't think
he was in the neutral zone. That's what I want to ask you. I don't think he's in the neutral
zone. Hey, Pete! Peter! Hey, Pete! 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 Hey, Pete! Pete! Watch the screen! Tell him!
That's Dan Goodspeed. Penalty on Orlando. I'll tell you what, this is not the Orlando team that went 8-2 during the regular season and did it virtually mistake-free all year long.
And they're facing third and long now. They're 0-for-6 on third down conversions tonight. Pathetic for the Orlando Rage.
Go! Set up!
Again, third and long, a passing formation. Kuklick buys some time as the tacklers tackle themselves, and the pass is incomplete. Looking for Diallo Burks.
And it also in danger of maybe losing their best asset, and that's their home field advantage, the fans they have here in the Citrus Bowl.
They've been taken out of it since late in the first quarter. And here's the punting unit once again. Jimmy Cunningham is checked back in the game. He's back to return the punt of Jay Taylor. He's got that elbow taped up, and he starts the return at his own 18-yard line. Tackled after a gain of 7. First and 10 for Pat Barnes and the Demons. A line that started out nothing but ugly is suddenly looking more and more respectable the deeper we get into this ballgame.
16!
Hand to Kelvin Anderson. Mark Campbell in on the tackle after a gain of 3.
The guy giggling it at the bottom.
I'm loving this.
I'm loving this.
Guys, look at the total yard. San Francisco 166, Orlando 24. Mike, go suit up for him.
I'm not sure I would help even at...
At 24 yards, you could double that. I know you could.
Green 19!
Well, the Rage en route to their win over San Francisco in week 2. Almost 300 total yards of offense. And again, we're talking about a team that went 8-2 during the regular season. They have been nothing but quiet since midway through the first.
First and 10, go 8-60 hook.
All right.
Rage coach Gavin Hall's already talking about their next possession.
It looks like he's going to take over the offense there.
Go 19!
Third and eight for Pat Barnes. San Francisco is 2 for 5 in third down conversions tonight. Dumps it off to you-know-who, and Kelvin Anderson's wrapped up. Patrice Alexander, he's the guy that runs the grill when the Orlando defense has a cookout, comes up with a big stop.
And Patrice needs to pick up some of the emotional slack left behind when James Burgess, the Orlando Rage's fine outside linebacker, had to leave the game.
So Mike Panasek on to punt. A live ball at the 46-yard line. Skinny Culver's the deep man for Orlando. Great hang time on the punt. Culver's there to begin the return at the 22. He's tripped up and stumbles across to the 33-yard line. Well, the Orlando offense gets another shot.
Come on.
Zero, 60 hooks on one, right?
60 refers to the pass protection. Six-man protection, all the wide receivers, three of them in this case, running the hook pass.
Kuklick over the middle, it bounces off the shoulder pads of Mario Bailey. Can't believe he got it in there to begin with.
Yeah, Kuklick with a lot of confidence,
you know,
storming a lot of young coverage.
A lot of young quarterbacks suffer from the Superman complex. They love their arms. They fall in love with their arms. They think that they can thread the ball through any needle. The more you play this game, the more you realize you have respect for the defensive backs.
And right now, it's critical not to turn the ball over.
Go!
3 minutes in ticking here in the third quarter. And that one's dropped.
And there's another thing in Brian's defense. He's had his best receivers, in that case there, Kevin Swain, but also D'Alio Burks tonight, drop balls.
Well, I think here Kevin Swain was looking at Kevin Casebehard running him down. Yeah. You're going to get hit either way, though, right?
Catch the football.
Zero tray, 960, 2-on-2, seam, all one, right?
Brian Kuklick started out the night, 4 of his first 5. He's 1 for 10 since. But again, a lot of those passes have been dropped balls. Looking at a 3rd and 10 here. That one batted up in the air.
There's the turnover.
Toby Wright, who was acquired by San Francisco from Las Vegas and just recently played his way into the starting lineup, comes up with a big pick.
Let's go!
The young man from Wake Forest has a very valid point.
It was only a matter of time. Any quarterback would get a little bothered with all the drops that Kuklick has seen tonight. You can continue to love your receivers for so long. Here's Kelvin Anderson again hanging on to the football for dear life. And breaks a big one, tackled at the 36 by Corey Gilliard.
I'll tell you, I'm very impressed with Kelvin Anderson's running.
Let's go back to the interception a moment ago.
Mario Bailey, the intended receiver. Kuklick put it there, maybe a hair behind him, but again, a catchable ball. And Bailey tips, and the result, a San Francisco interception.
Shift the trio left for Zorro. I'm one, ready? Go ball.
Kevin Casebehard in the middle of that once again.
Go!
After the first down run by Kelvin Anderson.
Red,
Barnes and the Demons at their own 37, rather at Orlando's 37. They spend their second time out of the half.
Ooh, and that could be troublesome, using up those timeouts in the third quarter.
How about San Francisco? Open up your golden gate.
I hear you, Connie.
Demons coming back.
I hear you. I'm with you.
Score tied at 16. San Francisco driving in the third quarter. And what you're watching is backup quarterback Jim Arianas taking snaps on the Orlando sideline. Brian Kuklick has been ineffective tonight. Not entirely his fault.
Jim, the next time the Rage has the ball, you'll be in at quarterback. What will you attempt to do? What are your thoughts?
Just going to try and come in and spark this offense and get something going. We're sputtering a little bit. Maybe this change will help us move the ball.
In the playoffs, do you feel any pressure in this situation?
No pressure whatsoever.
And if you believe that, Jesse...
I was just going to say that. Mike, do you believe that?
Note that four drop balls, and we saw Brian Kuklick finally... finally air out his receivers on the sideline. That might be part of the decision, too. That pass complete to Brian Roberson, who is in the midst of a big receiving night for San Francisco.
Jim Arianas has yet to take a single down, a snap from scrimmage this year in the XFL.
I think more important the question is how many snaps has he taken in practice? That's what you really got to ask, too.
Final seconds tick away on the third quarter as the plot thickens in Orlando. Don't go anywhere. You're watching the XFL playoffs on NBC.
Yeah, Rupert lands, and we had a draw check going. They were zero straight across the board, 6 yards deep.
This is the XFL on NBC.
Well, we're 15 minutes of football away from knowing which of these two teams gets a chance to play in the $1 million championship game. That is, unless, of course, it goes into overtime. We don't even want to think about that. Look out, Pat Barnes. He gets it away and has a completion. He finds Travis Moore with people up in his kitchen.
And I think Travis got just enough for the first down. Big play for... And a lot of cramps out there. You can see him working on the leg right away. You got to take those fluids, Mike. You know that from your Ironman experience.
Look at Barnes. Pat Barnes now the trainer of the San Francisco Demons.
At one point in the game, he carried off one of his injured players, teammates, to the sideline. Now he's massaging this guy's calf. The more things you can do, Matt.
I love this guy. Seriously. I mean, Pat Barnes plays with such nerve, if you will. I can think of another word for that, but nerve is probably the more appropriate, you know, family term.
And you're right, you touched upon it earlier. Everybody thought that this team might be in trouble with the loss of Mike Pawlowski, but this guy, every bit the same kind of leader that Mike is.
Waco, you want me to just run a go out there?
Because it's 33, you see 33 out there again.
I know.
But just
I don't have time, that's the issue.
I got you,
but just think about it.
Kelvin Anderson, who's been a big cog in this offense tonight. Use me, you can, anyway, I'll catch the ball, I'll run the ball, do whatever you want with it.
Well, as I said earlier, Anderson's really impressed me. He's very versatile, he's tough as nails, you can tell he likes to hit.
Well, we talked to Kelvin yesterday, you know, he told us he was just waiting to get down here. He was chomping at the bit to get into the XFL until his free agency was declared in Canada. He couldn't join the XFL. Once that happened, the Demons became a completely different team.
Matt, I'm considered out west Minnesota.
Well, I think in terms of the basketball world, you're an island unto yourself.
Wait a minute, you're from Milwaukee. You're not that far from me.
Well, you are an island unto yourself, though, Jesse. The Wolves are considered out west.
Okay.
Western Conference.
That's right. The Target Center's west of the Mississippi.
That's right.
So we got it covered.
Travis Moore being escorted off the field after making that grab.
In fact, Matt, I'll be there. I've been a season ticket holder now for about 7 years.
Not a bad basketball team either.
Oh, Garnett's always fun.
First and 10. Here's Kelvin Anderson. Penetration into the back.
Oh, Kelvin.
Ricky Bell couldn't tackle him. Rich Young finally hammered him out of bounds.
Kelvin not happy with the play call. Didn't want to run the sweep. Wants to run inside those tackles.
Easy.
A loss of four on the play.
Tarzan left. 35. Dallas, backside 28 to the left on one. Ready? You got Dallas.
Pat Barnes has completed 10 of his last 13 passes.
318. Set up. Hands up.
Over the middle and incomplete, looking for Jimmy Cunningham.
threw it behind Cunningham. Cunningham was open, but Barnes second not window. Delivering on that one.
Cunningham again, bear in mind, playing with a bad elbow. There have been injury casualties and significant ones on both sides of the ball.
Here we go. Shift. No, you're fine.
Injuries that could linger well into next week and could be factors should one of these two teams advance to the million-dollar game.
The Demons without their triple threat running back, Terry Bass, battling Brohm. This is Kelvin Anderson. This is between the tackles. And this is a positive yardage play. A gain of 7.
Well, and what it does do, it gets them in the field goal range. All they're looking at right now, Jim Skipper's get the lead. They had a long way to go. And let that kicker come in and try to put him in front and see if Orlando can play from behind.
Well, already tonight, Mike Panasek has hit a 42-yarder. Already this season, Panasek has won a game with 2 seconds left. That was week one of the XFL season. A former school teacher from Lebanon, Indiana.
This one just a little under 40.
He was reading Beowulf in a drama class a few months ago, and this one is right through. San Francisco has come back to take a 3-point lead. They trailed at 1 point, 16-0. We'll be right back. San Francisco Demons have not been very gracious guests tonight. After trailing 16-0 in the first quarter, they've come back to take a lead. This is Michael Black returning the kickoff. He's got a seam now and takes it back to the 37-yard line before Kevin Casebaharn gets him. Well, here it is, guys. Jim Arianez makes his XFL debut right here.
Go 0-960 choice.
What do you say, huh? Hey, we're not settling for anything less than 6 damn points right here, right?
Yeah.
Let's go. Let's go 0-960 choice on one. Ready?
Well, he certainly says the right things in the huddle. Sounds like a confident guy.
Let's see if anybody buys it.
Oh! His first snap in the XFL. Oh, and it's picked off! Dwayne Harper, the veteran, the 35-year-old veteran! A pick and touchdown for San Francisco!
Well, he said he wasn't going to settle for anything less than 6. The only thing he didn't have in mind was a San Francisco 6.
I don't mean to laugh at a man's misfortune. Dwayne Harper told us yesterday one of the reasons why he's still playing football at the age of 35 is his smarts.
Hey, we're going right back now. Let's go.
And the crowd here is stunned, guys. They're stunned.
They're out of it.
Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. What, the guy just squat?
They're here in body, but not in mind. They got nothing to think.
Go!
Here's the PAT try from Kelvin Anderson from 1 yard out. Okay. And it's good.
Let's go. It's not over.
Let's call that a rookie mistake on the part of Jim Arianez. He locked in on this receiver. Dwayne Harper read his eyes. He saw the wide receiver break down, and he jumped all over it, man. Kevin Swain breaks down.
Yes! I told you! I told you what!
And you know, Mike, that's why you do the tip drills on defense for plays just like that.
The once invincible Orlando Rage at home, 5-0 coming into this game.
All right, give it a go.
It was too quick and too easy at the start.
Maybe they pulled this guy too early.
Removed to start the quarter. Jim Arianez throws the pick. Dwayne Harper's the hero of the moment, but he's got good company in terms of the San Francisco comeback.
And there's a lot of football left.
Scott Kloman takes the kickoff. Another chance for Arianas.
Jim, go 0, 960, 939 angle.
Hey, let's go! Let's go! Let's go 0, 960, 939 angle. Hold on, ready?
There's Jeff Brohm. They've started through the first 6 weeks of the season. A guy who was perhaps en route to MVP honors before he was taken down for the year. Ariana's next pass. This one's complete to Mario Bailey. And they keep him in bounds. The clock ticking. John Haskins, Abdul Salam Noah on the tackle.
A little cheeky out there.
Tempers are flaring out there because I'll tell you, you can read it all over Orlando. Their fans, their team, they're stunned. Best record in the XFL, 8-2, and they're in trouble.
Undefeated at home during the regular season. Down by 10 here in the fourth.
Fumble!
Still alive!
Frisco's got it!
San Francisco recovers! James Williams. The Demons take control. Nothing has gone right since halftime for Orlando.
Ever since that bad snap. It was that bad snap on the punt.
This is a veteran head coach, Galen Hall.
Come on, guys.
Still surprised that he took out Brian Kuklick, a guy who's got much more experience than this young man, Jim Arianas. Handed him the football while Orlando is still very much in this game, down by 3 points. An interception for a touchdown and a fumble, and San Francisco's got it again. I'm shocked.
Eight turnovers tonight at the Citrus Bowl. And here's Barnes and the Demon offense. This is Kelvin Anderson. They're going to grind away now on top by 10 with under 10 minutes left to go. The pick by Dwayne Harper. And then the fumble on the next possession recovered by the veteran James Williams. This is where the veterans have really stepped up for San Francisco.
It was counting us out. We all we got, baby. It was counting us out. We all we got.
There's a bulk up Dennis Rodman.
We're going to do it.
And in stark contrast, young Brian Kuklick. He and the rest of the Rage just wondering what's happened.
Round 19, set up.
Flag, delay a game call.
Coach, you made a quarterback change. You inserted a quarterback that had not played one down. Do you think you made the move too soon now?
No, not at all. Jim's played with me before. I know what he can do. And I don't question that at all.
It's worth noting that Jim Arianas had played under Galen Hall in Europe, and they went to a title game together. But that was Europe, and that was about 15, 16 months ago.
Big difference. A big difference.
319.
And again, Brian Kuklick didn't play all that poorly. Had Mario Bailey and Dalio Burks made a couple of catches that they should have made. Could have been a different story.
Play action, and that one passed too far. Well, there was talk coming into the game of the strength of schedule, guys. San Francisco had a tough road to home. They played a schedule tied for the second most difficult in the league. Orlando's was, by our math, the easiest based on the winning percentages of opponents all year long.
Well, the other point is, too, that game, second game of the year meant nothing. And we were right on with that because this is a different San Francisco Demon team that showed up here in Orlando.
You know, Jeff Brohm wishes he was in there right now.
Brohm 19 tonight.
Third and long now for Barnes and the Demons. Look out. He gets out of the way of a pair of tacklers, but is finally dragged down. Ben Huff there on the sack, and that'll bring on the punting unit.
You know, that was actually a better play rather than throwing an incomplete pass because it keeps the clock running.
Mike Banasek on to punt. Skinny Culver, the return man for Orlando.
Skinny needs to break one here.
Culver.
There's Culver to start it at his own six. All kinds of flags on the play. Wendell Davis was there to make the tackle, perhaps a bit too early. We'll sort it out when we return. Orlando takes over deep in their own territory, down 10 late.
Let's go, offense!
If you're going to San Francisco, be sure to wear a flower in your hair and be sure to congratulate the San Francisco Demons on a great comeback so far. The job not finished yet. Plenty of football left. First and 10 for Jim Arianis in the Orlando Rage, looking to go downfield. That one was almost picked off. Toby Wright was looking for his second one of the night.
I tell you what, if he played for like Galen Hall like that in Europe, he'd have got yanked and never would have been put in the game.
Well, let's go. 0-60 wide under.
Feared receiving core has not accounted for a whole lot.
I'm telling you guys, they panicked after halfway through that first quarter.
Second and 10 now for young Jim Arianis. Over the middle, he's got a receiver complete to Kevin Swain. Still on his feet. Dwayne Harper runs him out of bounds.
A late flag.
Flag on the play. A reminder, tomorrow, Chicago and Los Angeles, the hottest team in the XFL to end the season had been the Chicago Enforcers. They're in the Coliseum tomorrow. 7 o'clock Eastern on UPN. That's a rematch of what we think was the best game of the season during regular season play.
Oh, man.
10-yard penalty be administered from the end of the run.
That's Diallo Burks.
You look at this film. Wait.
Well, they still get the first down, but they get it with 10 yards more for the touchdown.
Been a frustrating night for Diallo Burks. Among those Rage receivers to drop a couple of balls tonight.
What do you got back here?
Rip, rip! Oh!
So first and 10 from the 28-yard line. Oh, Jim Arianis, heads up. Welcome to the XFL. Meet Carl Hansen.
And Orlando's offensive line ranked the best of the league. Consensus among the coaches.
Go, Trey, rocket left on one. Ready? Oh.
Been a complete breakdown tonight.
Wow.
Gary Patrick, the center.
Oh!
Arianas dumps it off, and that one's dropped, and another flag on the play. He was trying to get it out to Michael Black.
What is with the Orlando receivers tonight, Mike? They've dropped over a half a dozen footballs right in their hands.
You know, just talking about Diallo Burks. And here's a guy who was fourth in the XFL in receiving yards.
Holding number 79, offense. 10-yard penalty, repeat, second down.
Burks, the best average in the XFL with 19.4 yards a catch. Totally non-existent.
Let's go, zero trade.
Get ready for the turnover here, too, with this quarterback. I can see him trying to force something.
You know, I got a flashback to the first quarter. It was 16-0 Orlando. Terry Battle was taken out of the game for San Francisco. That's their triple threat guy, big part of their offense. And it looked like this was going to be a laugher for the Rage. Arianis can't get out of the way of Carl Hansen once again. Second sack of the series by the Stanford product.
Oh, man.
James Burgess, who has missed the majority of the better part of three quarters, coming back into the game, but I'm afraid this is...
Yeah.
The emotional tide has already swung in the other direction.
And Mike and Matt, statistics aren't looking good here for Orlando. 0-for-8 on third down conversions tonight. And here they're facing their ninth with third and a mile.
Up top, into the corner, Scott.
Oh,
Coleman is there for it.
Wow.
And they convert on third and 27.
First down, Orlando. We will show you the definition of offensive pass interference.
Well, they're not dead yet. Whether they did it or not, they got away with it.
Well, that's Kloman's here. Okay, I don't have enough room. Now push you away there. Pretty clever stuff.
It's called creating space.
Yeah, yes. If you creative can't do wide it, receiving.
If you can't do it with speed, you do it with your hands.
First and 10 from the Orlando 45 now. They're going to need a lot more of that here late in the fourth quarter. A wobbler.
Give me one in the face.
Intended for Diallo Burks.
And that is not a happy head coach right there.
Gas it.
One play. 960, 212. White team gas on one. Ready?
34 of those 60 yards came on a play just two plays ago. That completion to Scott Kloman. Take that away, and Arianez is really struggling. Look out for Jermaine Miles.
He's got a man open.
Diallo Burks. And he's going to break it. And Orlando is right back in this thing. A 55-yard touchdown play from Arianez to Burks.
They're going for three. They're holding up three fingers. They're going for all of it.
Dinner!
Silent all night long. Diallo Burks finally breaks the big one.
26 unanswered San Francisco points. And Orlando finally gets now, on the board here in the fourth.
Why do you go for three when it's 26-22? Why not go for two and get yourself within a field goal? Or one and you can tie it. I question this. I'll tell you, Coach Hall, he's doing some strange stuff tonight.
This is a three-point PAT attempt from the 10-yard line. Arianez pass.
You got it.
And they convert Mario Bailey. Oh, my goodness. It's a one-point ball game, guys. Ha-ha! Don't uncork the champagne just yet in Florida or California. We'll be right back. Don't bend over to pick up any change you might have dropped in the couch tonight. Now a one-point ball game. Brian Roberson to return the kickoff. And the crowd is right back in this ball game as a result of this touchdown pass to Diallo Burks.
No player in the XFL has more big play potential than Diallo Burks. He may have been setting that up all night long, and a great throw by Jimmy Arianez.
He set it up by dropping four of them.
He got behind Kevin Casebehart and then was off to the races. And here's the three-point after try from the 10-yard line. The pass complete to Mario Bailey. It's a nine-point scoring sequence for Orlando. On the ground for Kelvin Anderson. And now it's a keyed-up defense, and James Burgess is back in there. He got in on that tackle.
And remember, Orlando has all three timeouts, so they can stop the clock at will.
The man whose motor's always running, and he's given them the emotional lift they needed after that nine-point swing. Unbelievable.
He was knocked out in the first quarter. He has come back with his Orlando Rage down by just a point. Just over 2 minutes left to determine who goes to the million-dollar championship game.
Well, they're throwing this one. There's no running backs.
That's Jimmy the Jet Cunningham. Another guy that's come back after injury. And a first down for San Francisco.
David! Dana! Dana!
That gentleman was a huge play right there facing second and 10.
San Francisco had to move the chains at least once.
We got to eat it all the way up. You know what I mean?
They're taking it to the two-minute warning right now.
It's all right. We get one more first down.
Jim Skipper well aware of the timeout situation.
Now, Mike, why wouldn't you use a timeout before the two-minute warning, and then you get it again?
Doesn't matter.
No, it's a two-minute warning.
Two-minute warning. Time on the field.
All right, here we go. Here we go.
Pain, pig, sacrifice, risk. All for a shot at $1 million.
The best team in the XFL, guys.
They've won four straight.
I don't think nobody's going to stop us right now.
One team stands between them and the million-dollar game.
Division champs, baby!
The Western Division champion Extreme continue to light up the scoreboard and have million-dollar dreams of their own. The Enforcers, the Extreme, the XFL Playoffs, Sunday on UPN.
The Enforcers and the Extreme among those watching tonight to find out who will be the first team to earn a shot at the million-dollar championship game. It's San Francisco on top by just a point, 2 minutes left. Barnes wants a block and wisely slides to the ground.
And wisely stays in bounds. Make him use the timeout.
Orlando has two of them left.
Orlando better be careful here, too. They're bringing about nine men up in the box, Mike, and they could get burned on a pass right here. They're assuming, of course, as everyone is, that San Francisco is going to run the ball every play.
And Pat Barnes, the kind of quarterback not afraid to take a gamble.
Or full.
This game has seen eight turnovers.
Coach, I need to play.
Here we go.
I'm going out there.
I don't know.
The timeouts inside of 2 minutes are only of the 30-second variety. And Barnes didn't really have a good chance to consult his coordinator there on the sidelines.
3-0 left. Okay, give me 6 ocean.
3-0 left. 6 ocean. On one. Ready?
Go. 3-19. Miami, Miami. Green.
Second and 10.
19.
The hand to Calvin Anderson. Dropped for no gain. James Roberson was there on the tackle, as was Mark Campbell.
Another Orlando timeout.
And they're down to one on a third down.
An interception on his first play.
No huddle. Get up. What? No huddle. What?
Galen Hall hoping to get another offensive series.
They got one timeout left. How many timeouts they got? One?
This is it.
They got one?
They got one, Jim.
Yep.
Good stuff.
Could anyone have envisioned this scenario after it was 16-0?
Oh, look at this. Out of the shotgun. They're going to put it in the air.
Third and 11. No backs. Barnes, look out. He's got good
shot. He's got it.
A huge first down for San Francisco.
And that may have won the ball game for him.
A 31-yard pass play.
That's you. Baby.
One here. That one's for you, Mom. That one's for you, Mom.
Pat Barnes never had any doubts. You know that? Never had any doubts.
Yeah, last week Pat's mom was bawling him out for yelling at a referee after a pass interference call. I'd love to see her in her living room right now.
And guys, that was $1 million third down play, maybe.
Pat Barnes' mom is turning the furniture upside down in the house right now. She's so happy.
Smackdown in her own home.
Calvin Anderson, it's academic, maybe a gain of a yard, and Orlando burns their final timeout.
Last one, right?
They've got to try to strip the ball loose now because you know they're not going to put it in the air.
70 seconds.
It all came down to that one play and the gamble, the big third down play. San Francisco electing to go no backfield out of the shotgun formation. Barnes patiently waiting for Cunningham to get open. And the Jet did his job and held out of the football.
He had Corey Gilliard coming up in his face, and he still got it away.
Get up.
Get up.
Jimmy, the Jets, a guy that might have to have surgery on his elbow after that ligament problem earlier. He's back in there tonight, and we don't say we're sure about
that. He don't need no surgery.
But, you know, he was hurt a moment ago and had to come out of the game. He just makes the biggest play of his life.
Matt, you're exactly right. Had this been week five of the game, you know, not a playoff variety, Jimmy Cunningham would not be back in this football game.
We were going to get it, boy.
Skip's starting to feel good. Starting to feel the playoff love. Oh, my. They were down 16-0 to start the game 6 minutes into the first quarter. San Francisco had never come back from a deficit of greater than 6 points all year long.
Coach, obviously this one's a foregone conclusion. Did you ever think you'd get this result the way this thing started?
Well, we always have confidence. Like we tell our guys, keep our composure. It's not over till it's over. It's not in till it's in. All right? And the game can start any kind of way. Either they get a big jump going or we get one going and it's not over. There's a lot of football left and we've persevered all year and it's a tribute to our guys.
Let me ask you this. Do you have to make a decision on a starting quarterback next week?
Well, hey, we'll deal with that when it's time.
That's fine.
Hold it up.
A little rough stuff there after the whistle. Well, Pat Barnes doesn't care.
He didn't go down. He never took the knee. He just started backing up. And Orlando just kind of stood around for a while. But that's the ball game.
They were 6.5-point underdogs. They trailed 16-0 in the first quarter. They were coming off an absolute blowout last week. They got smoked in Los Angeles, shut out. And on the road, San Francisco has beaten previously home undefeated Orlando.
And that man, the difference tonight, Pat Barnes and that gutsy third down call.
My goodness. An enormous upset, maybe the biggest of the season. The San Francisco Demons are playing in the $1 million championship game.
Probably one of the biggest starts and finishes in your career. Can you talk about tonight's game? Didn't look good early on.
No, it didn't. You know, we had a lot of adversity. We fought through it. I think our team has had a lot of character all year, and it showed through. The game's 60 minutes, and you know, we're going to compete for $1 million now.
All right, good luck next week.
Well, we know half the picture. San Francisco, the runners-up in the West, will go to the $1 million championship game next week, and you can see it right here Saturday at 8 p.m. Eastern on NBC. Another good one tomorrow as Los Angeles faces Chicago to determine the Demons' opponent. A great night of XFL playoff football has come to a close, and the Dogs have their day. The underdog Demons with a huge road upset. Tune in to NBC tomorrow at noon Eastern. First, tune in next week for the $1 million game. Noon Eastern tomorrow at NBA Triple Header. And tonight, Saturday Night Live with Renee Zellweger. The $1 million championship game is next week. We'll see you then.